I continue now with the lecture where I will demonstrate to you how you can export the historical data of your broker. And as a resource file to this lecture, you will find a script that will help you do it so you can download it. Now, if I am on the generator, you will see that the first tab says historical data, and I have data source, and MetaTrader-demo is the data that comes by default from Expert Advisor Studio. And if I just click on it, you will see that I have many other sources of historical data from different brokers. So what you need to do in order to import your historical data in the software is to go back to your MetaTrader platform and place here the script. So how you can do that? Go to File and then open data folder. After that, click on MQL4 and go to scripts. You need to paste it in this folder. Here it is, EA Studio Data Export MT4. And of course, if you're using MT5, you need to paste the script for MT5. You will find attached both scripts to this lecture. After that, close the folder, go to scripts and click on refresh. This will force MetaTrader to compile this script, and you will see it displayed below. And before I use the script, I will show you how you can take the maximum bars of your MetaTrader. If you install it for a first time, what you need to do is to press the home key on your keyboard and hold it. Now, because I have done that already, it's not moving, but if you install your MetaTrader for a first time and you press the home key on your keyboard and you hold it, you will see that the chart is moving. Basically, it will move very quickly like that, and it will load more historical data. So do this for the asset you want to trade. If you want to trade euro dollar, just go to M1 first, press home key and hold it. After it stops moving, then go to M5 and do this for all time frames. And you need to do this just one time at the beginning. After that, with the time, you will collect more historical bars when the new data comes. Keep in mind that most of the brokers don't provide a lot of data at the beginning, which is very normal. So the best way is to collect it with the time. I don't suggest you to download the historical data from your history center. So if you click on tools, you will see history center. But if you download data from here, you will see that this data is not actually from your broker. So for example, if I want to download the euro dollar data from the history center and I double click on it, and I double click on M1, for example, you see it's loading, and I click on download, you will see the message that pops up. You're going to download data from the MetaQuotes Software Corporation History Center, but your account is opened with GFD. This is the broker I selected to use. So they're warning you that you are downloading not the data you need. You're downloading the data from the MetaQuotes software company, which is actually the company that developed MetaTrader platform. So what you want to do is to create actually the strategies over your historical data, or if you're doing a backtest of any of the strategies, it is again a good idea to do it over the historical data of your broker. And one last thing about the data, if you install your MetaTrader for the first time, you will hit the 65K limitation. So if I go to tools and I click on options, you will see in charts that there is this 65K limitation. And normally this is how you will find your MetaTrader for the first time when you install it. What you need to do, press 9 and hold it, and then do this for maximum bars in chart as well, and then click on OK, and you will remove this limitation. Press the home key again, hold it, and it will load more bars, more than 65K. After that, go to the EA Studio Data Export MT4 script and drag it over the chart. You will see a small menu which will ask you for the maximum count of bars you want to export. Normally I leave it to 200,000, but if you do it for first time, 100,000 will be alright because you will not have a lot of bars at the beginning. And then you have the spread. You can enter the current spread. You can see at the current moment it's a little bit higher for euro dollar, but this is because I'm recording just after midnight, and after that it will go back to normal. And if you want to enter value, it's good, but normally what I do, I leave it to zero, which will round it to the higher number. So if I leave it to zero, and for example my spread with euro dollar is normally at 3, 4, 5, this means it will round it to 10. And if you have spread higher, like if you have spread 23, 24, 25 for any currency pair, it will round it to 30. So I leave it to zero, and here is the commission in currency. For this broker, I have $6 of commission for each lot traded. Okay, so I will leave it to 6, and I click on OK, and you'll see what will happen. On the left up corner, I will see all of the data exported. I have 200,000 bars for euro dollar on M1 chart, same for M5, and then for the rest, the number decreases, and euro dollar 1440 as daily chart. I have 1576 days or bars. And after that, I need to go to file, open data folder, and I go to MQL4, and then I go to files. This is the data I am looking for. These are the JSON files that were just created. And then I will open Expert Advisor Studio. Let me move to my other screen. I go to data, and here is the drop zone. This is where you need to drop files, or you can just click to upload them. I normally drop them, so I just take them and drop them in the box. You can see all of that data is imported and uploaded in EA Studio. So if I go to the generator and I click on the data source, I will see the data, GFD demo, euro dollar on M15. You can see it is from 21st of February 2018 till the current moment, which is 11th of December 2019. And actually this is the time zone of the broker, with me as just 15 minutes after midnight. But you can see the broker is with GMT time. It is a little bit after quarter past 10 p.m. And now after I have the historical data, I am ready to show you how I generate strategies with Expert Advisor Studio, and you will see how quickly that generator actually works. Thanks for watching, and I will see you just in the next video. Cheers!